Hi, hello everybody, and I'm gonna speak a little bit about the place I work and what we do and why it is important to, let's say, events like this. So European Investment Fund, who are we? We're actually a European Union institution, and our role is to develop risk financing for entrepreneurship and innovation in Europe. We are European institution, but the only one who actually has shareholders, and also the only one who has a private shareholder. So we are set up as a fully fledged investment organization. We have a 4.5 billion share capital. Most of our shareholders, like majority of shareholders, comes from European Investment Bank and European Commission, but we also have roughly 26 financial institutions from all over Europe, including also some of the leading European banks. Currently, we have 13.5 billion of assets under management already invested in European ecosystem. And these investments have catalyzed additionally 79 billion of investments from various stakeholders, private and also public. We are driven by financial return, but we also have a policy objective, which is financing a creation of digital economy in Europe. We operate on a full spectrum of development of young companies, so idea is that any stage of a young company can get a financing through us. We start from technology transfer and business angel co-investment facilities. We have a microcredit, venture capital, fund of fund products. We started to develop a social impact investment products. We have a private equity, growth venture capital, and mezzanine fund products. And we also have a large portfolio of debt and guarantees. Typically, people also ask where our money comes from. Majority of our money comes from European Investment Bank, who in short term received the money from the member states. We also receive substantial amounts of money from European Commission, from the Innovation Investment Budget. Usually those allocated on the 5-6 year basis. And then we also work actively with various national and regional governments for specific regional products, especially in the regions where there is a lack of actual financing tools and active players. I speak a little bit more details about the venture capital. That's a team where I work. So the model we operate is that we never invest directly in the companies themselves, because it's simply impossible to absorb, to invest such amount of money by building a team. So we work with intermediary model. So we invest in actually professional investors who do this job for us. So our job is to help and finance those professional investors as a venture investment fund. So there is actually about 600 of them at this event. So up to date, we invested roughly 5 billion already in European venture capital, and indirectly, it has financed above 4,200 European innovation and technology companies. So our portfolio consists of roughly 280 venture funds, and we have been at the market for 17 years. Our main objective is to develop European venture capital asset class as a very attractive class for private investors, and to attract as much private capital into European venture financing as possible. And I think we are actually starting to see the results, and I will speak a little bit about this. One of the also important role we have is when the first time managers, emerging managers, new team come to the market, it's actually not so easy to raise a fund, venture fund, if you have never done it before. There is many reasons, lack of track records, maybe lack of relationship to large asset manager investors. And that's where we, I think, we are playing the most important role, that we help those young managers to get on board their first investors, including us. And we have actually, I think, take pride in quite a few managers, which are now some of the leading names in Europe, where we have created them, helped them with the fundraising of their first fund. And then I speak a little bit about venture capital, what's going on in Europe. I think there is been in the past a little bit a general perception that actually you know, nobody wants to invest in European venture. There is, you know, always a problems. Look at US, look at China. Actually, it's not really the case anymore. I think probably the growth of Slush from 300 to 10,000 people is also a good evidence in here. But I speak a little bit about things what we see in our portfolio. So in 2013, we have seen a breaking, record-breaking year in terms of exits and money coming back from venture funds back to us. And unsurprisingly, actually, 2014 is looking even better. So last year, we had about 17 exits in value above $100 million, and much more, so smaller exits. This year, we are by far already surpassed this. There was a quite large scale IPOs this year of European companies actually happening in Europe, which is a very strong trend, and hopefully it continues. Another interesting element, which is one of the best indicators, I think, is our venture portfolio is outperforming our private equity buyout portfolio for already more than 2.5 years steadily. So there is always this kind of notion that it's safer and much more attractive to invest in buyout. Well, it seems to be it's actually not the case anymore. It's not such an obvious case anymore. Also, what's interesting, we have been sort of slicing our portfolio, and I think this is also a very good indicator of a new performance in Europe, is that portfolio we built between 1999 and 2005, and portfolio we have built between 2006 and 2011. If we compare those two portfolios, our 2006 portfolio by far outperforming the prior portfolio, which is also basically speaking about a level of performance of the funds we have in this portfolio, and meaning also level of performance overall on the European market. Interesting as well, fundraising in Europe for European funds have always been difficult. People always take a long time to raise a fund, and the larger the fund, the longer it takes. This trend seems to be reversing, actually. We have seen already last year, the first time, we have seen oversubscribed funds where people just have to tell investors, I'm sorry, we are not taking anymore because we have more than we can invest. Interesting, the same trend continues this year, and the demand sometimes is so much greater that it's quite interesting. I think for us it's also interesting because our role is in a sense to make ourselves redundant. So we are quite happy, you know, when we are not needed. It's a bit a sad kind of job that you have to do, you know, that you are not longer needed, but this means that we are actually succeeding. Also, there is obviously what we see is a very significant interest from outside of Europe capital, so from US and from China, from Asian capital, interest in growth financing in Europe. So it's becoming pretty competitive, and it's also one of the reasons why some of the European funds focusing on growth is raising a lot of money very fast. And then I think an important trend which has started a few years back and which I think now reached its tipping point is rise of venture capital as a service mentality, because European venture capital in the past used to be a little bit like, you know, big guys with a lot of money and a lot of power. I think it's the trend is reversing now, where entrepreneurs have much more choice and competition is much higher. So many firms have reformed themselves. Many new firms have appeared where they actually, the main service is to be a partner for entrepreneur and not just a board member and investor. And this is important trend which also have risen the quality of the whole ecosystem. Now I have only 2 minutes and I speak a little bit. Is this something we're gonna continue to see? I have just one example. So Europe in general have always had a long heritage in certain areas. Now that we have a global platforms like mobile distribution platforms, you know, Android, App Store, web, actually we start to see results. I want to just maybe focus on one area, fashion and luxury. So Europe has always been one of the leaders in this area. I mean, if you look at the global brands, most likely they are Europeans. And then what we have seen happening in e-commerce, there is Alibaba in China. There is Amazon in States, But then there is a whole bunch of very interesting creative companies out of Europe which operate in this space, which actually neither Chinese nor US even understand. So when one of the entrepreneurs of this company, from one of those companies, Farfetch, he went to US 2 years ago to raise the money. Actually, none of the single US leading US VC funds even knew about ASOS or YOX. They had no clue. And they asked, why don't those designer brands sell on Amazon? Well, he said, well, why don't they sell in Walmart? So, you know, there is some areas where actually Europe does have a very long heritage and where we will see more results. I think if you think about retailer services, just think about a variety of supermarket models, of food retailer supermarket models we have in Europe. We're definitely bound to see it translating in the digital space. Think about IKEA and coming out of Europe, and think that in future, I'm pretty sure we will see a digital IKEA. Actually, I think we already maybe have seen one here at Slush. Healthcare and many other things. So I think we are going to see the results continuing. And just last message. This is how Europe looked in 1999-2005. There was just a few companies actually you could look up and say, oh, this was great stories, I want to aspire to this. But in last 6 years, it has changed dramatically. Now we have so many success stories built on actually all those fundamentals. So I think we hope that and we are pretty sure that things are going to continue this way. Thanks a lot. Thank you. Bye.